For businesses, having full control and visibility over your tools is crucial. Enterprise-grade security, data sovereignty, and compliance are non-negotiable. Now, this is where Appsmith really shines. As the leading open-source, low-code platform, Appsmith empowers businesses to build powerful internal tools in their own infrastructure, adhering to specific network constraints and data policies. So in this video, I'll walk through the process of self-hosting Appsmith on Amazon AWS in three straightforward steps. First, setting up the prerequisites on AWS, which includes network permissions like security groups and key configurations. Also, we'll configure AWS instances specifically to run Appsmith. And last, we'll deploy Appsmith to your AWS infrastructure. Now, I've designed this video as a comprehensive step-by-step guide, suitable for all users of any kind and levels. However, if you are an advanced user looking for a quick setup, check out our Terraform modules in the link in the description for a faster deployment option. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, here we are in the Amazon AWS console, specifically the AC2 dashboard, because it's here where we're going to set up our Appsmith instance. Now, before we do that, we have two important prerequisites I want to go over. The first one is the security group. This is the mechanism how we define how people will access our instance. Now, the very basic setup should be for Appsmith to have access via HTTP to the port 80, HTTPS to the port 443, and via SSH to the port 22. Now, again, depending on your network topology and your infrastructure, you might want to run Appsmith internally and have access via AAM or different routes and rules, but this is the basic setup to have access to the Appsmith instance. Now, the other thing I wanted to show you that we need is the key pair. You can create a new key pair. I already have one, but you can create your own key pair to have access via SSH. This will download a file to your computer that you will need to keep handy, because that's the pen file that you will use to authenticate via SSH. But with those two things, we are ready to create our instance. So go back to our EC2 home dashboard, and you will see this giant orange button that says launch instance. Click over there and you will give it a name. I'm going to call it Appsmith, and you will see some of the applications and OS images that AWS has for you. Here we can find for Appsmith. It's that easy. We have made this so easy for you. Now, at the beginning, you won't see any results, but actually you will see in the AWS Marketplace AMEs some results. And here we have Appsmith, which is the Enterprise Edition or the Community Edition. Depending on what you want to use, you will select either one of those. I'm going to run the Enterprise Edition, so I'm going to click Select. You will see a glimpse of the information of what this means, what the total price is going to be for running this instance, the product details, pricing, usage, etc. If you scroll down, you will be able to subscribe now or subscribe on Instance Lodge. I'm going to click this one. That way I'm going to set up everything that I need. And after I initiate my launch of the instance, it's going to be built. Now, after we do that, we will be presented with the configuration of this image. The first thing is the instance type. We recommend nothing below the T3 minimum. That's the bare minimum configuration. Obviously, if you go beyond that, it's going to be even better, but the basic should be T3 medium. Then the key pair. Remember that I mentioned about this just a second ago. That's it. I'm going to select the one that I created. And then the network settings. Again, remember that I mentioned about the security groups. Here I'm going to select a existing security group and find the one that I created called Appsmith. There you go. And then you have the configuration for the storage. The image that we have on Amazon is going to be pre-configured with the default settings that we believe are the best suited to run Appsmith. So if you want to increase the values that we have by default here, the better, but this is the bare minimum, and we should have at least 15 gigabytes of SSD, general purpose SSD. And that's fine. You can also go to the advanced settings to define like your domain or your AMN instance profile, your host names, etc. But for this particular case, I think I'm good. I think I'm going to start launching my instance right now. Let's click on launch instance. And I want to say something very important here, so you don't get scared. As you can see, Amazon just told us that this is successfully initiated. Now, that doesn't mean that Appsmith is fully running and is ready for you to start using it. Because what AWS is doing is just provisioning the operating system. Then it's going to use Docker, which uses the different images that we have for Appsmith. So it's going to pull the images from Docker and is going to initiate those images. But after that also happens, we have a first initial setup set of scripts that is going to set up everything for you. Now that takes some minutes, but it's only when the image is being installed. That's not going to take that amount of time after. So again, be aware that if we go to the instance, you will see that everything is running. Like AWS is telling us this is running, this is fine, but that's not the case. If you copy the public IP address and you visit it on your browser, nothing is happening. Because again, right now what's going on is probably the Docker images are being pulled and the setup script is being executed. So how do you know when that's done? Well, first of all, you can just wait in the browser and see when the public IP address is actually showing something, or even the better, you can go to the logs, clicking here on actions, monitor and troubleshoot, and go to get system logs. Now, you won't see here anything at the beginning, but if you start refreshing, you will start to see some logs of what Appsmith is doing behind the scenes. Again, that's going to take like 5 minutes and you will see that the logs that everything is done, and that's when it should be ready to visit on the browser and start using Appsmith. So again, let's just give it a couple of minutes and that should be done. All right, now we are seeing some logs here. If you scroll down, you should see some information about what's going on, setting up the Docker images, pulling them down, setting up the environments. And then if you scroll down, you will see some of the different aspects of Appsmith behind the scenes, the startup of the different keys, etc. And at the end, you should see that the execution of the final scripts are done. So that means that we should be good to go. If we go back then to our instance details and we copy the public IP address, we open a new browser tab and visit it. There you go. We're running Appsmith and now we can finalize our setup. Let's call this our name. There you go. Our email, our password. Let's make it strong. And we can continue. It's gonna ask us for our knowledge in terms of Appsmith, if it's gonna be for a work project. And then we're gonna set up what's basically the trial for the enterprise version, which you can start free, or if you already have a license, you can set that up. I'm going to add a license that I have already here. And there you go. I have everything done. I'm not going to set up any type of data source right now. And there you go. We are running Appsmith Enterprise Edition on Amazon AWS using the AME image. And as you can see, it's extremely easy to do. And now you're ready to do that and start using Appsmith internally within your systems.